Hi, my name is Fred Kohler, and I'm a member of the Solidworks training team. Parent-child relationships are key factors in creating the design intent of the part, leading to better designs and more robust models. Knowing feature relationships also makes reordering features, suppressing, and deleting features faster and easier. Let's get started. Features are typically built upon other features, and in doing so, create relationships defined as parents and children. So what does parent-child relationships really mean? The parents are the features that it needs, while the children are features that need it. Let's look at this part. The first base feature in this model is extruded to form the initial solid body. When I add the next feature, another extruded boss, it's sketched on the top face of the base feature. Let's look at the relationships for the second feature, boss extrude 2. There are two ways to display the parent and child relationships, a list or a graphic representation. To see the list, I'll right-click the boss extrude 2 and click parent-child. The parents of this feature are sketch 2, boss extrude 1, and the origin. Why the origin? There is a coincident relation between the center of the sketch rectangle and the origin. The children include sketch 3, boss extrude 3, and the applied feature, fillet 3. The graphic way to display relationships is to use dynamic reference visualization. I'll right-click the top level component, or part name, then click dynamic reference visualization, parent, and also dynamic reference visualization, child. The upper blue lines above the selection represent the parents. The purple lines below the selection connect the children. Let's use these parent-child relationships to help us reorder some features. I like to move the shell 1 feature above the knob so that it is not shelled. If we tried to reorder the shell and place it after boss extrude 2, we'd get an error because you can't place the child before the parent. Let's look at the parents of shell 1. They are boss extrude 1 and boss extrude 4. There are no children. Some editing is needed, so I'll right-click shell 1 and click edit feature. The reference that prevents the reorder is the face of the boss extrude 4 feature, so I'll deselect it. The parent is now only the base feature. Now when we reorder shell 1, it will work. But there is still one more issue. The fillet 1 feature should be before the shell feature so that the shell includes the filleted faces. Checking the relationships, we can reorder this feature too. What about deleting? I'll click boss extrude 4 and press delete. When we click advanced, there are options for delete absorbed features, like sketches, and delete child features. I'll select them both and click yes. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access more great content.